Welcome to the Layers tutorial for the Duval Maps property application. In this video, we will be discussing different layers and how to work with them. Let's take a look at the layers we have to work with by clicking on the Layers tab. This is the Layers window. Layers are organized into categories, and to see the layers within each category, click on the Expand button next to the category name. I've expanded Community, and now we can see the layers in this category. You have the option to turn one layer on at a time by clicking on the checkbox next to each layer, or you may turn on all the layers in the category at once, simply by checking the box next to the category. Next to each layer, you will see either a symbol or another expand box. If a layer has more than one symbol to represent its data, we can click the expand button next to the layer title to see its symbology. For example, because there are multiple zip codes in Duval County, the zip code layer uses different symbols for each unique zip code seen here. Some layers, like the ones found in the property category, are too detailed to see at such a large extent. As you can see next to the layer panels heading, that we will have to zoom in to smaller extents to view these layers. Once we have zoomed in to an appropriate extent, we will see the property layers category has become active and is displaying any layers that are turned on. Don't forget you can also view the layers you have turned on and their symbology in the legend located in the upper right-hand corner of the map window. Take some time to explore the categories to get familiar with where each layer sits. If you want to find a description of a layer you may not know or have forgotten, we have included supplemental layer information you can get to by clicking on the Layers Information link at the bottom of the panel. Now that we know where the layers are located and how to work with them, we can start viewing and gathering information, details, and data stored within the layers. Let's turn on a couple of them. Let's select Census 2010 under Community, as well as the Parcel layer under Property category, if it's not already selected. This is usually a layer that is turned on by default. I am going to close the layer panel for now, so we can have a better view of the map, but open the legend for reference of what layers I have turned on in the map. Let's click on a parcel. Notice the pop-up that appears is not the parcel data, but the census data. This is because the census layer is over top of the parcel layer. We can click Zoom To, and the map will zoom out to the census tract that is selected. Here you can see that. To view the parcels pop-up, we will have to click the arrow in the pop-up heading. If you want to return to view the census data, simply click on the back arrow. We are now viewing the pop-up data for the parcel we originally tried to select, so let's zoom back into it. Some layers pop-ups will have more than just a Zoom To link. They may have some more links that will provide you with supplemental data. For example, you can see the RA number in the parcels pop-up is linked to the property appraiser's website, where you can view all the data they have for the selected RA number. The parcel pop-up also gives us the choice to view more parcel details, which will bring up this detail panel, which provides us with more data than just the pop-up itself. You can learn a lot more about this side panel, its search functions, and other details in our search tutorial videos on our YouTube page. The pop-up can be maximized using this button, and the X closes the pop-up. Take some time, explore the layers, and take note of any supplemental links in case you are ever digging for some serious detail. This concludes our layers tutorial.